Hey, what's up everybody? I am Dan Davis and I hope you're having an awesome day. In this video today, I'm going to be talking about redirecting one domain to another through Cloudflare. If you're new to the channel, make sure you like the video, subscribe and hit that bell if you don't want to miss the next video. So this is what we're dealing with. You've got your domain set up, your site's running through Cloudflare, all is good. And then you might have your secondary domain set up through your hosting as a parked domain. And then you go and try and access the parked domain in your browser. You go and type it in, you get hit with this. And this is the problem. And this is what we're gonna fix today. Now it's pretty common, websites might have multiple domains. So you might have .com and you might have .co.uk and you want them both to work for your website. So let's say you have a website and it's running through Cloudflare, but you wanna park or redirect a different domain name to your website. So for example, you may have mydomain.com, but you want people that visit you via mydomain.co.uk to be taken to the .com website. Now in cPanel, you would just set up a parked domain or you would create redirects, and that would be easy enough because they'd both be using the same SSL certificate. So let's start with this website. So if we go to, you know, the website, all good, page loads fine, it's got an SSL certificate, everything's cool. But let's say we want to go to the .com, you get hit with this. And this is the problem, and this is what we're going to fix today. Now, yes, you can click continue to site, and it'll take you there. But obviously, that's no good, because some of your visitors, they might have gone already. So what we need to do is fix that problem, and I'm going to show you how we do that through Cloudflare. So the first thing you're going to have to make sure that you've got is that both domains are set up in Cloudflare. So as you can see here, we've got the mxfs.co.uk set up in Cloudflare. Now we need to make sure that we've got the .com also set up in Cloudflare. So the first thing you want to do is click add a site. And when you're adding a site, obviously you just add in the new domain. So .com is the one that we need to add. And just wait a second for that to load up. And for this, you can pick the free plan. And just let it try and work out what the DNS records are going to be. So the first thing we need to do is to make sure that the DNS records are accurate. Now, once Cloudflare has worked out what it thinks they should be, you can then go in and basically delete whatever Cloudflare suggests, because we need to add in our own records for this to work. So the first one we need to add in is the root. And then it's important that you enter this specific IP address in, which is 192.1.2.3. Leave it as proxied, so it needs to go through Cloudflare. And then we just need to add one more record, which is www. And again, the IP address 1.9.2.1.2.3. Make sure it's proxied. And then that's it. You're done. And then just click continue. So once you've added the DNS records in Cloudflare, the next thing we need to do is we need to make sure that the domain is actually pointing to Cloudflare. So we need to go to our domain registrar and we need to update the name servers to the ones that Cloudflare give you. So these are mine, and I'm just gonna go and change my name servers. So most domain registrars are going to be pretty similar. So, you know, what you'll see here might vary to what you've got. But basically, once you're logged in and you pick the domain that you want to manage, you just need to go to the DNS section. And then we need to update the name servers that Cloudflare has given us for that domain. So in this case, I'm using these ones. And then once they're set, we can save the changes. Normally this will happen pretty quickly, but you may need to hang around and wait up to a day for this to complete. But generally speaking, it shouldn't take that long. Now, once you go back to Cloudflare, you can ask Cloudflare to check the name servers. You might be lucky and this might happen straight away. Here's some quick default settings that you need to manage. So yeah, you can leave that one enabled. Always use HTTPS, yes. So none of these will be required because we're just redirecting the domain. So we can leave that as it is and we can leave that on as well. So save and finish. And this is where now we've got to wait for the propagation to happen. So we need to make sure that the name servers have been updated. So little trick, obviously you can get Cloudflare to check by clicking check name servers. They'll email you once the name servers have been updated and the website is, the domain is now going through Cloudflare. And a tool I like, or a website I like using is what's my DNS. Accept that. And then you can enter in your domain, the one that you're waiting for to be checked. And then, as you can see, it's happened already because these are the IP addresses that we assigned in the DNS settings in Cloudflare. So we know that's been done. So we can now go back to Cloudflare. Okay, cool. So this hasn't taken too long, maybe like a few minutes. So we've come back to overview. We can see great news. Cloudflare is now protecting your site. So now we know that the secondary domain, the .com domain that we want to redirect to the .co.uk is now going through Cloudflare. So there's one more step in the process now for that to finish working, is we need to create some page rules. Okay, so in order to set up the page rules, first thing we need to do is go to rules, page rules. So we need to create a page rule. And then, because we want this to work, whether the user types in www or not www, we're going to give it a wildcard. And then we're going to put the .com in. So if anyone hits mxfs.com with or without www, and then anything afterwards, so it may be the about page, contact page, we want all of them to be managed and redirected to the relevant pages on the main website. So what this will do is give it wildcard, enter the domain in, /, and wildcard. And then the setting we want to do is, if you scroll down, we want to pick forwarding URL. All right. And then for this, we want to pick 301, which is a permanent redirect. So then we need to enter the URL of the destination that we want the users to go to. So if we take the URL from here, so we want to make sure after the /, we've got the $ and 2, which is the wildcard, so that it will, you know, redirect all the sub pages that we want, such as, you know, about, contact, you know, profiles, anything that they hit will actually get taken to the relevant page, so they don't all get redirected to the home page. And that's it, you're all done. Yeah, so if you click save and deploy page rules, so you should have something set up like this, and it should show as enabled. And then the only thing left to do then is to test out this redirect. So yeah, so once you've done everything, it is important to give it just a bit of time, because obviously it takes time for things to settle with DNS changes. So if it doesn't work initially, don't get too stressed. Just wait a little bit, and you know, it will kick in. So now the only thing left to do is to give it one test to see what happens. So, you know, let's have a look. Let's try mxfs.com now and see if we get the redirect. So you can see in this test, we've put no www, just the test. And what happens? Yep, we get redirected, and we get redirected to www.mxfs.co.uk. So let's try once more, mxfs.com/contact us. Let's see if we get redirected to the right page. And we do. We've gone to the .co.uk and we've gone to the same page that we'd requested. So that's it. That's how you create redirects through Cloudflare. If you find this video useful and you want to see more content, make sure you subscribe, like the video, and yeah, we'll see you on the next one.